Laser engravers can be incredibly useful in the workshop, perfect for adding fine details and taking your project to the next level. But let's be honest, these machines aren't toys. Just like any traditional workshop tool, they need to be handled with proper care and precautions. The laser beam can seriously damage your eyes if you're not wearing proper protection. It can create toxic fumes when burning certain materials, and it's powerful enough to do real damage if you get too close with your hands. So today, I'm dealing with all of that. I'm building a laser station, a safe setup where I can engrave and cut without having to leave the room because of the fumes, without risking my eyes if I glance over while working on something else, and without any risk of injury if I get too eager and reach in too soon to grab the finished piece. Let's get to it. I want my laser station to be a permanent and accessible part of my workshop, something that fits in with the rest of the space, has room for all the safety gear, and is ready to go at any time. But I also want it to be mobile. I've got a few open corners in the shop, and I like the idea of being able to move things around when needed, without disassembling everything and rebuilding. In an earlier video, I showed how I built my basic workshop from the ground up, including that long workbench made from modified IKEA cabinets running along two walls. Well, I've got one of those cabinets left over, and that's going to be the base of this laser station. They're surprisingly sturdy, and with a few tweaks, they can work great in a workshop. The cabinets themselves are cheap. It's the doors and drawer fronts that drive the cost up. That was one of the bigger expenses when I first set up the shop. But this time, I got lucky. I found a door in the IKEA clearance corner. Actually, I found three, and of course, I grabbed all of them. So I'll be using those not only for the cabinet front, but also for the top and bottom panels. Now, the doors aren't exactly the same style as the rest of my shop, which might bug me later on. But hey, beggars can't be choosers. This will have to do. Because the station needs to be mobile, I bought a set of inexpensive wheels to attach to the base. The panels I'm using are made of MDF or a similar high-density material, which should hold small screws just fine. I pre-drilled the holes to prevent any cracking and to ensure a solid grip. The screws are just a millimeter too long, so to keep them from poking through the base, I add a few washers. So far, so good. Next, I attach the top, just like the bottom panel, leaving a small overhang in the front so it clears the cabinet doors. There's quite a bit of overhang in the back too, but I have a plan for reinforcing that a little later. Now, if you worked with IKEA cabinets before, you'll know the sides are basically hollow, cardboard or something close, and won't hold screws. But along the edges, there's a solid reinforcement, so I carefully measure and make sure my screws hit that section to properly secure the top and bottom panels. With the cabinet body assembled, I move on to the door. IKEA might get some shade in workshop circles, but honestly, I love how quick and simple it is. The door's on and aligned in no time. Looking pretty good so far. The wheels glide smoothly on my laminate floor, and there's great storage space behind the door. I'll show you what goes in there a bit later. It's time to deal with the big overhang at the back. While the panels are strong, I want zero flex, so I add support battens, one on each side. I didn't bother painting them, since they'll be tucked out of sight. Now, it's time to start adding equipment, beginning with the star of the show, the laser. A big thank you to TOOCAA for providing this machine, the L2 laser engraver. It's a perfect fit for my setup. TOOCAA really focuses on safety, and this laser has several built-in protection features that make it ideal for a shop like mine. I'm curious to see all the safety mechanisms advertised with this machine. This is the 40 watt version, and there's definitely enough power here to damage your eyes, or even your workshop, if you're not careful. Let's get it assembled and take a closer look. Inside the box, you've got the orange polycarbonate panels for the enclosure and the aluminium framing that holds it together. Both the panels and the aluminium feel thicker and sturdier than I expected, which is a good thing. The orange panels are designed to filter out harmful blue light emitted by diode lasers. You'll also find LED bars and some electronics pre-mounted on the panels. Having built-in lighting inside the enclosure is great, and I suspect the other components are sensors. According to the specs, the enclosure includes safety sensors that deactivate the laser if the lid is opened during operation. In the main compartment, everything is neatly arranged in custom cut foam, a user guide and some sample materials, a box of screws, hinges and other hardware, a small plastic case with an SD card, USB stick, USB cable and all the tools you need for assembly and maintenance. I like this branded TOOCAA hex screwdriver. Nice touch. There's the laser unit itself, heavy, solid, and clearly labeled 40 watts, so I know I got the right model. The unit also includes a built-in protective shield in front of the laser head for additional eye protection, along with a port for connecting an air assist hose to help clear smoke and heat from the cutting area. The kit includes an electric fan designed to mount on the enclosure, as well as fittings for connecting an external exhaust hose. I'll talk more about that in a moment. Then you have the power adapters, the feet for the enclosure, and a pair of serious-looking safety glasses. That's a third layer of eye protection. TOOCAA is clearly taking safety very seriously. At the bottom of the box, you'll find the pre-assembled base. This is the frame that houses all the motion components and drives the laser head around. I'm glad this part comes assembled, cause it looks like it could be a headache to build from scratch. Let's put this thing together and see how it fits into my laser station. The manual is actually really well done. It starts off with a bit of background on TOOCAA and the machine itself, goes over safety precautions, and then lays out a clear parts list with reference numbers that are easy to use during assembly. The instructions are clear and easy to follow. There are 32 steps in total, but they're all very manageable. Let's start with the base. It comes mostly pre-assembled, but you do need to attach the feet. They have rubber soles to reduce vibration. After that, it's time to install the laser unit. You just loosen the lever on the holder and slide the laser in place. That's also how you adjust the laser height when setting up a cut. A USB cable connects the laser to the base, and it's fastened by screws, which is great because it keeps the connection secure even when the laser is moving during engraving or cutting. That's it for the base. Now let's move on to the enclosure. I start with the back panel, which holds the electric fan and the exhaust fittings. The fan has its own power adapter and isn't connected to the main unit. I won't be using the fan in my setup, but I'll explain more on that later. Next is the aluminium framing, followed by the side panels. Before assembling them, I attach the brackets for the gas struts. Everything goes together with screws into pre-threaded holes. No guesswork here. At this point, I also connected the LED lights. I initially thought the wires and connections might end up exposed inside the enclosure, but they're tucked away neatly in the upper rear corners, hidden from sight and out of the way. The top panel over the rear section screws in next and includes mounting points for the front lid. All the panels are clearly labeled with stickers showing orientations and neighboring parts, so it's almost impossible to mess up. I added a few more fittings for the gas struts and snapped on the magnetic TOOCAA logo badge before installing the hinges that attach the lid to the enclosure. After that, I installed the front of the lid and a large handle that makes it easy to open and close the lid. The final step for the enclosure is the gas struts. They snap into place and immediately give the lid a smooth, controlled motion. To secure the whole enclosure to the base, there are three mounting points on each side. Everything feels solid and stable. And now, it's time to see how the whole setup fits into my new mobile laser station. Looking really good so far, but I'm not done just yet. I want this laser station to include a few more safety measures. Eye protection is already well covered with three layers of protection, but I still need something for the smoke and fumes. TOOCAA has a solution for that too. You could run a hose from the machine's exhaust fittings outside and use the electric fan to pull the fumes out, but I want this station to stay mobile, so I'm going to try something else. TOOCAA's smoke purifier. It's designed to filter the air internally without needing to vent anything outside, perfect for a flexible setup like mine. The purifier comes with wheels, but I don't want it sliding around inside the cabinet, so I remove them. Some of the wheel screws also hold the bottom panel in place, so I reinstall them with washers to make sure they don't protrude further than before. That also keeps them handy in case I want to reattach the wheels later. I added some rubber pads underneath to keep it steady and absorb any vibrations. To hook up the purifier, I had to modify the enclosure slightly. I drilled one hole for the exhaust tube from the laser and another for clear air to escape. Ideally, the purifier is good enough to release the filtered air directly back into the shop, but just in case, I might add a fitting later to connect it to a fan mounted above this corner for extra peace of mind. The purifier fits perfectly in the cabinet. I routed the cables from both the laser and purifier to a power strip inside the enclosure, so I only need to plug in a single cord to power the whole station. Time to test it. It works like a charm. Pulls in all the smoke without breaking a sweat. And even with the clean air venting straight into the room, there's no noticeable smell or haze. It really does the job. I'm super happy with how this turned out, but I'd love to hear what you think. Would you do anything differently? Drop a comment. I read every one of them. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.